Commutative law. So in the first commutative law, we are seeing that a plus b equal to b plus a. Now let us see what is going inside the truth table. Since there are two values, that is two inputs a and b, so the formula is 2 to the power of n. So since 2 to the power of n, since there are two inputs, so 2 square is 4, 4 combinations. So that is why we have written a, b. So under b we have written 0, 1, 0, 1. And under a we have written 0, 0, 1. Now in the left hand side we are seeing a plus b. So a 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 0 is again 1. And 1 plus 1 is your 1. And on the right side, right hand side, we are seeing b plus a. So same thing, 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, and 1 plus 1 is 1 as well. So the values of a and a plus b and b plus a are same. That is why we can say that a plus b equal to b plus a. Similarly, if you do for a multiply a into b equal to b into a, so since here will be four combinations like the previous one, so here we'll just multiply the two constants. So 0 into 0 is 0 for the right hand side, a multiplied by b. 0 into 0 is 0, 0 into 1 is 0, 1 into 0 is again 0, and 1 into 1 is your 1. Similarly, for the right hand side, b into a, 0 into 0 is 0, 0 into 1 is 0, 1 into 0 is 0, and 1 into 1 is your 1. Since both the values of a into b and b into a are same, that is why we can say that they are equal. So this is how commutative law works. Now distributive law. So in distributive law, we are seeing the first one is that a into whole bracket b plus c is equals a into b plus a into c. Since there are three inputs, so there will be eight combinations. 2 cube is 8. So under, so we have seen in the table a, b, c. So under c we have written 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, and 0, 1 8 times. Then on b we have written 00, 11, 00, 11. So it is 8 times. Now 40, 41. So it becomes 8. Now b plus c. So 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 plus 1 is your 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 plus 1 is your 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. And 1 plus 1 is your 1. Now a into b plus c. So 0 into 0. 0 into 0 is 0. 0 into 1 is again 0. 0 into 1 is again 0. 0 into 1 is again 0. For the rest of the part, 1 into 0 is again 0. Now, for the last three terms, 1, 1, 1, and another b plus is 1, 1, 1. Since they both of them are 1, that is why we have written 1, 1, 1. Similarly, a into b. So 0 into 0 is 0, 0 into 0 is 0, 0 into 1 is 0, 0 into 1 is your 0 as well. Then 1 into 0 is 0, and 1 into 0 is your 0. And for the last time, 1, 1, 1, double 1, and b is 1, 1. So 1 into 1 is your 1, 1 into 1 is your 1. Now a into c, 0 into 0 is your 0. So if you see that this 2 0 part, these two are interchanging, and only on the last line and on these two lines the values are same, that is why 1 1, and everything all else are 0, that is why we have written everywhere else 0. Now again we will follow the same thing, just add it up. 0 plus, so if you add, just look over here, for the first 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and similarly 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you just add it up, you will see that 4 5 zeros. And for the rest of the four terms, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. For the three terms, since there is at least one present, that is why we are seeing three ones. So if you now compare the right hand side part with the left hand side part, we are seeing that A into B plus C and AB plus AC are same. That is why we can say that this law is valid. Next, A plus BC is equal to A plus B into A plus C. So here, similar to the previous one, A into whole bracket B plus C, which is AB plus AC, similar to here. Since there are three terms, so there will be eight combinations. So under C, there will be 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 8 times. And under B, we'll write 0, 0, 1, 1, 8 times as well. And under A, we'll write 4, 0, and 4, 1. Now, if you just multiply the values of, as first we will just multiply BC. So B into C. So for the three line, we are seeing that at least one of them is zero. Since in multiplication, if any one of them is zero, so the answer, ultimate answer will be zero as well. Then for this line, both of them are one, so one is coming out. And for the next three lines, we are seeing that at least one of them is zero. So that is why three zeros has been written. And for the last line, last two are one, that is why we are seeing one. Now if you just add up the value of A plus BC, so what do you see? For the first three lines, we are seeing 0, so we have written 0. Then, for the remaining one, at least one of them has 1. That is why all of the rest of the part, 5 numbers are 1. Is 1. And for A plus B, we are seeing that for the first two numbers, if I use the green color, really better. So if the first two number, we are seeing that okay, there is zero, so this is zero. And for the rest of the values, there is at least one present. That is why rest of the six numbers are one as well. Now A plus C. For A plus C, we have to again analyze what are the numbers, so that will be quickly. So for A, what do you see? That for the first two numbers A and C, 0 is there. Then again 0 and 1, so 0 plus 1 is your 0, 1. Then again 0 and 0, so 0 plus 0 is 0. And for the rest of the part, at least one of them has 1, so that is why rest of the 5 numbers are 1 as well. Now if you try to multiply A plus B into A plus C, what do you see? You are seeing that at least for the first three numbers, at least one of them has 0. That is why first three numbers are 0. For the rest of the part, all of them are 1 as well. That is why if you multiply, you are getting 1. Now if you just track down A plus B into A plus C and compare with the left hand side, what do you see? That the left hand side and the right hand side values are exactly same. That is why this law holds. Then associative law. Associative law says that A plus whole bracket B plus C is equal to A plus B whole bracket plus C. So since there is again same three inputs, so under C I have written 0, 1 8 times. And under B, we have written 0, 0, 0, 1, 8 times. And under A, 4, 0, 4, 1, 8 times. Now, A, so we will just add up B plus C. So if you look up, 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 1, 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is again 1, and 1 plus 1 is 0, 1. Now for A plus whole bracket B plus C. So 0 plus 0 is your 0, 0 plus 1 is your 1, and for the rest of the numbers, at least one of them has 1, that is why rest of the part is 1. Now a plus b. So if you just add up the first numbers, 0 plus 0, first two numbers, we are seeing 0. And for the rest of the numbers, at least one of them has 1. That is why I have written 1 in each places. Now if you just add up a plus b plus c, so a plus b plus c. So you are seeing that, okay, on the first line only, you are seeing that there is 0. There is 0. And on the rest of the lines, at least one of them has 1. That is why rest of the 7 places, there is 1. Now if you compare a plus b plus c with a plus whole bracket b plus c, you are seeing that both of the values are exactly same. So this law holds. So we'll do up to here. In the next video, we'll continue the laws.